Melissa put a link to Jeff Gellman's seminars.
Awesome. You'll definitely want to go to the seminar. Guys, I'm in Green Bay, Wisconsin this weekend. That means if you're anywhere within 300 miles, I'm sorry, west of Green Bay by about 40 minutes. I'm chopping it up. D-E and then space P-E-R-E. The Pur. I don't know how to pronounce it. You want to take a crack at it?
No.
Okay. So.
De pair.
Joelle, don't you dare turn this. Or Joelle or Melissa, don't you fucking do a damn geography meme on this, please. Okay. I'll veto that one. What I want you to do is go to the seminar next. Uh-oh. All right, guys. Hey, how are you? We got the camera down. That's it. Okay. That's it. We're done with the show. Hey, everybody. How are you? Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training. This is Linda. This is the one I'm married to. All right. So.
Why? Does somebody think you're married to Joelle?
No, not at all.
Oh, all right then.
Sometimes they don't call you my wife. They say that lady or something like that.
Well, this is why I put myself out there as Mrs. Gellman.
Well, anybody can call themselves Mrs. Gellman, but they're frauds.
Who wants to, though?
Well, to make good. I'm sure there's many days that you probably can't move over anymore.
No, I can't. I'm at the edge.
So.
I'm at the edge of glory.
Bingo. All right, this is a Q&A show. Without you asking questions, I have no answer. I have no agenda. I have no idea what I'm going to talk about. So I do this 3 times a week. Tonight's show is an hour. So top chats will be a priority tonight. The reason why, there's a little dollar sign down at the bottom that gets your question up to the top of the queue. And what happens is I have to answer right away because we can't get through all the questions. If you're brand new to my world, I rehabilitate dogs. We train hard-to-train dogs. So aggression, leash reactivity, massive anxiety, nervous, fear. We also train, obviously, obedience too. But our big thing is stopping unwanted behaviors. The gist of this show is how to stop an unwanted behavior. You're going to hear a lot of people saying, how do I stop this? How do I stop this? How do I stop this? The only way to stop an unwanted behavior is through the proper application of a punisher. That's how you do it. You don't redirect. You don't ignore. You don't reward what you want to stop something. You reward what you want, but not to stop something. So we're going to talk a lot about punishers. So if you're brand new, that's the show. Here we go. Ask your question. And ready? Go. Ready.
Tom.
Hey, Tom.
Hey, Tom. Hey, Jeff, I got a German Shepherd who is now living with another German Shepherd. Neither of them have been trained. Should I train both of them at once or one at a time?
What the fuck?
Or should I make my brother train his dog?
What the fuck, Tom? Why didn't you train the damn first dog first? Or are these not even your dogs? If one of these dogs is your dogs, you've been on the show, the dog should have a good head start in the training. You have to do both, parallel training. One at a time, keep one in the crate, train one, put it back in the crate, mm-hmm. train the other, and then eventually when the dog can start doing duration, you can train them both out at the same time. But make your life easier, one at a time. And so, yes, tell your brother to train his own damn dog. Next.
GMC Tech.
Yes.
What are your guys' favorite dog breeds as personal pets, and what are the ones that are easiest and hardest to train? Also, had to phase out using a bonker on my dog due to the fact that after I winged it at him, he could pick it up and play keep away with it. E-collar training going great so far.
Okay, so I'll ask the third question first. If your dog is playing with your bonker, you did not bonk properly. You failed. You tossed it at the dog. You didn't throw it at the dog. The last thing any dog ever wants to do when I throw a bonker is play with it. But meanwhile, they're not afraid of it either. Like right now, my three dogs are sitting right next to me. I'm waving this over their heads. They don't care. I can hold it right up to them. They don't care. They're neutral to the bonker. So when you say no and hard, real hard, people don't throw it hard. As far as I personally like German Shepherds. I like working line dogs. I like a working breed dog, a high energy dog. That's what I like.
You don't like Chihuahuas?
No. So we have two Chihuahuas too. Those are Linda's dogs. Linda likes small dogs. This is the thing. As far as easiest and hardest to train, what's easiest for me doesn't make a difference to anybody else. What's hardest for me doesn't make a difference for anybody else. I don't find breeds difficult or hard. Some dogs that have got low energy, lack of motivation, no drive, those can be a little bit more challenging. Next.
Giga Geeks. Rescue dog is reactive when trying to put any kind of collar on. Dog literally flips out. Once on, he refuses to lead, to be led with without serious pulling. What's going on? How to overcome collar reactivity?
Okay, Geeky Geeks, your dog has trained you. Number one, who's running the show over there? Who's running the show? So remember, no collar stops a dog from pulling. Dog training stops a dog from pulling. So you're going to want to make sure that you train. As far as the dog freaking out, the first time that it happens, let the dog do it. Go ahead, process it. Go get on the floor and have a temper tantrum. I'm talking about the dog. Go ahead. That's fine. Or correct that. You can correct all that nonsense too. So, but if you're using a prong collar, most people, what they do is they put a collar on a dog and then they allow the dog to do the work. No, you do the work. Collars are communication devices. Any type of collar is a communication device. Without the proper conversation happening, the collar does not do as it's supposed to do. Most people, what they're doing is they're being reactive instead of proactive. So watch my videos on how to have a good conversation with a dog through a prong collar. Next.
Mike. Hello, guys. Happy to report. I took Maddie off leash for the first time today. She did great. Hashtag Mrs. Gellman Mondays.
Mike, super proud of you. That's awesome. Magic to off leash is, so remember, maybe I mentioned this in my seminar. As soon as you let that dog off leash and it starts moving a little bit away from you, recall it back at a higher stim to let that dog know, I know you're off leash, but we're working. It will save you, like, your dog's life one day from chasing prey. Next.
Cassandra. Thank you guys for everything. We have made more progress in the last 2 weeks than we have in years. My dog is like a new pup, relaxed, excited to work, and attentive. Thank you.
Really? And you applied a punisher? You used a shock collar? You used a prong collar? You said no? And your dog has made more progress in 2 weeks than 2 years? And it's relaxed, excited to work, and attentive? Impossible. Yeah, I'm being sarcastic on a dick level because I'm tired of all the lies.
Wouldn't dick level be like lower? Down here?
Mine would be down to the fucking floor. Okay. So listen. I'm calling people out on the lies. There's all this nonsense about it'll ruin the relationship. Bullshit. Cassandra probably had a shitty relationship with her dog. 2 years of working with no results. That's called a crappy relationship. Now Sandra can actually have a relationship and start building a relationship. Kudos to you, Cassandra. So proud of you. Next.
Michelle says, good evening, Jeff and Linda.
Hello, Michelle.
Evening, Michelle. Melissa says, hi, Jeff and Mrs. Gellman.
Hey, Melissa.
Alexia, I can't see anything. Anyone else?
Okay, listen. You probably just came off the bondage show. Take the blindfold out. Okay? Take the blindfold out. And
take it out of where?
Take it off. I was thinking about a ball gag, actually. Take the blindfold off. And ask for your wrist cuffs to be redone, unless you're a top, and then you leave the damn bottom just the way they are. Next.
Melissa says, Mrs. Gellman Mondays, hashtag, next. Of course. Alexia, as soon as they go live, the video will start. She probably came on a little early.
No, we came on late because we were talking about the guest. We just had a wonderful guest.
She came
guest.
On early.
Yes. Oh,
we weren't late.
Yeah, we had a wonderful guest just check into our Airbnb, so we're chit-chatting about that.
Next. Okay. Amethyst, first time sitting in tonight. Can't wait.
Are you still there?
What?
Are you still there?
There where?
Yeah, sitting in. They asked the question probably before all the nonsense started, and it's been nothing but nonsense. Next.
I'm confused.
Look.
T.L. Bracey.
Yes.
I had a man come over to do some yard work. My young 4-year-old Aussie barked at him a couple times as he was digging out a post. As he was raising the shovel to chop some roots, the dog nipped him.
What was your dog doing that close to a handyman? Mm-hmm. And I'm being serious.
Oh, nipped him in the ass. Totally caught me off guard. He's always loved meeting people.
Okay, so... That doesn't make it worse where he nipped him. So what I would say is...
But in the ass.
Right. So what I would say is this. People come over to do work at your house. You put your dogs away. Your dog goes to the vet. You muzzle up your dog if you're worried about it. Put your dog away. At a minimum, keep it on a lead. At a minimum, keep it on a lead. Now, you can proof the dog off of that. But even if you do, that is just basic... What I want to be the standard operating procedure of dog ownership... People come to your house to work on stuff, your dog goes away. Let's make it standard for everybody out there. Next.
Silver Snow. My two dogs got into a fight and are now terrified of each other.
Good.
They try to attack each other out of fear, in between crying and shaking. What can I do to repair their relationship and help them trust again?
Well, first of all, don't worry about repairing the relationship and help them trust. Let's keep everybody safe right now. Got it? Let's keep everybody safe. Number one, no baby talk, no affection, no feeling bad for them. Number two, they should both have crates, sleeping in separate crates as they should be done in the first place if they weren't. Got it? When you're not home, put them in separate crates. Number two, if you haven't started a hardcore obedience program, which won't fix aggression, but I still need them under voice control, start doing that now. No resources such as food involved in that when the two dogs are out. They eat in their crates. Watch the affection. Don't feel bad for them. I already said that, but I'm going to say it again because that's very, very important. I don't know if they'll like each other again. They may hate each other forever. That's not the end goal. The end goal is to never have a fight again. That's the end goal. Show leadership. Take control of the home. That's not through yelling or screaming or being mad or being angry. It's through massive amounts of structure, leadership, guidance, rules, consequences. Next.
K9W dog training. Good to see you guys.
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Well, we can't see you. Good to hear from you.
We kind of see, next. Virtually. TL Bracey. Oh, wait, we did that one. Mackenzie.
Hey, Mackenzie.
Hi, guys. I'm saving up money to get a Skype session. I have a dog that's people and aggressive and no structure. I just need some more insight on the correct way of approach.
Okay. Even before you save up enough money, 100% of the information is available for free on my YouTube videos. We're, 529 of a Q&A, and I've done probably, 6 years of radio shows prior to that. So that's another 300 radio shows, as well as thousands of other videos. So between podcasts, free videos, daily content, all of my stuff on Facebook and Instagram, all the answers are there. Start doing it. Don't worry about the breed of the dog or the back end of the history of the dog. So I remember one time someone's like, hi, I need advice on how to stop a beagle from pulling. It's like, I just did a whole show on how to stop dogs from pulling. Doesn't make a difference if it's a beagle or a German shepherd. It's a dog. So don't worry about the breed of the dog. Don't worry about anything. All the information is right there. So I want you to be, if you can't, if it takes you a month to save up enough money, what I want you to do is you should be in a better place in a month. And maybe you even have to cancel the Skype, ask for your money back because you fixed the problem on your own. That would make me happy. It literally would make me happy if you never have to hire me. All right? But I'm here for you if you need me. A couple of top chats, $5 top chat came in first. Giggy Geeks, rescue is the new to me, day one, and can't get cow on him. He flips bite, runs away, takes two of us to pin him down. He has to overcome reactivity. Don't pin the dog down. Take it slow. Get a slip lead on the dog. Get a slip lead, like a British slip lead, put it over the dog's neck, have it walk around slowly. Just walk. Don't take the dog off the property. Walk around. Walk around your house. Walk around your yard. Massive structure. Kennel up, come out of the kennel. Kennel up, come out of the kennel. Default wait for food. Use food for all basic commands. Don't worry about any training cowards at all right now. Take everything slow. $4.99 top chat. Grant. How do you e-collar condition a human aggressive dog will attack when you try to pet or give food, e-collar heel? First of all, you definitely don't physically touch the dog and don't use food for rewards right now. The first thing you should be doing, Grant, is muzzle training the dog. You want to muzzle condition this dog. If you can't, you got to get on the dog somehow. But the dog, all human aggressive dogs should be worked on muzzle. I just say that just because I don't know if you're how quick your reaction time is to a bite or how well you can read a dog that's about to bite you. So that's the first thing. Number two, massive amounts of structure. As far as how do you start the remote collar work, recall, heel, or place are three good commands to do that with because those are all in motion. Either moving away from you or coming towards you. Next.
Next one is from Yuko. Good evening. Do we have to use Mini Educator if we attend your seminar? We have Garmin Sport Pro now.
No, you don't. The thing about the Sport Pro, which is a good unit, sometimes they run hot on level one. The way I train is Sport Dog does not, and Garmin, So Garmin and sport dog, Garmin, which is Tritronic. So Garmin and then the sport dog, they're not conducive to how I train obedience, which is at lower levels. They're conducive to how I correct for unwanted behavior because that's at a higher level. So absolutely bring that. I'll see what I can do. Worst case scenario, I'll let you use one of mine during the seminar. But ideally, I need to show you how to use the one you have. Next.
Kaylee, good evening, Jeff and Mrs. Gellman.
Hello, how are you, Kaylee?
Mario, hello, it's been a while since I've caught a live show. Have a good one.
Thanks, Mario. Well, now everything's fine that Mario's in the house. Next.
Ryan, at what age do you feel it is appropriate to start using the tools as punishment for bad behavior, prong, e-collar, and bark collar?
Well, bark collar, you can throw on the dog at 14, 16 weeks. I mean, depends on what the behavior is. So inappropriate behavior, dangerous behaviors, you can stop right off the bat. As far as like obedience, it's more about, so for obedience, it's more about how well does the dog know it. So no matter how old the dog is, we don't correct for obedience until we know the dog has got a good comprehension of it. As far as bad behaviors, you know, I mean, I'm not gonna do an act of God on a 12-week-old puppy, that's for sure. So by 6 months old, most act of God stuff can be done, but a lot of times you don't have to do act of God stuff because the dog still is technically micromanaged. Next.
What age is the earliest you can start using a prong or e-collar on a dog?
It depends on the size of the dog, usually 12 or 14 weeks old. Next.
Crixus. Hi, Jeff and Linda. Dogs do speak, but only to those who know how to listen. You have taught me to be a good listener. Thank you so much for all your help and guidance.
Oh, wow. Thanks.
Mackenzie, I've been working with my dog for about a month. Some small changes, which is good.
Mackenzie, awesome. Next.
Melissa put a link to Jeff Gellman's seminars.
Awesome. You'll definitely want to go to seminar. Guys, I'm in Green Bay, Wisconsin this weekend. That means if you're anywhere within 300 miles, west of Green Bay by about 40 minutes. DePere, I'm chopping it up. D-E and then space P-E-R-E. DePere. The purr. I don't know how to pronounce it. You want to take a crack at it?
No.
Okay. So.
De pair.
Joelle or Melissa, don't you fucking do a damn geography meme on this, please. Okay. I'll veto that one. What I want you to do is go to the seminar next.
Karen.
Hey, Karen.
Hi, Jeff and Linda. When walking my dog and he starts getting highly aroused, leash corrections don't work. I high stim and he gets angry. I have to stand away from him. Is this normal to overreact?
JSD, your dog doesn't fucking get angry, okay? Your spouse does. Listen, dogs, they're not getting angry. Your timing is probably slightly off. It's slightly off. So usually dogs that ramp up after a correction, you applied the punisher or the information too late. So someone's already freaking downed a fifth of tequila. You don't start talking to them about stopping drinking. It's too late. You wait till tomorrow. It's the same with the dog. So that's probably what it is. The dog's not angry at you though. Next.
Amethyst.
Yes.
Hi, Jeff. We've got a 22-pound, 4.5-month-old Amstaff.
Wow, it's going to be a big fucking dog.
When are we supposed to start a prong collar? If the smallest is too big right now, should I remove prongs? Have not yet bought one yet.
So yeah, you can start your dog on you're gonna need a 3 millimeter. You can start your dog on a 225. I haven't really ever put a prong collar on a dog that fit perfectly the way it is. You're always adding prongs or taking prongs off. Okay, just remember that. That's why the links come off next. You can start now next.
Donde Cabin, hello.
Hey, how are you, Donde?
Alexis, had my first client on Saturday using the stranger protocols you explained in your videos with board and trained dog. Shadow client dog went from going ballistic to making good decisions, starting slow with him.
Oh, congratulations. Always start very slow. Next.
Morgana. Hi, Jeff. I'm a newbie to the channel. I recently started using an e-collar on my 9-month-old Newfie. While on walks, he is doing so well. Love this channel.
Morgana, welcome to the family. I'm glad you're here. If you can make it through one of these shows, you'll be a fan for life. That's what I always tell people. I also tell people that when you're thinking about hiring us, if this is the only thing you see, don't judge us by it, because I can't be this way in the office. We're not this way in our company. We're way more professional, but this is entertainment. The content is good. The answers are correct, but it's an entertainment show with very truthful, honest, blunt, serious content. But believe it or not, it's funny. I had a woman in today, has to be in her 60s. Huh. Has to be in her 60s. Mm-hmm. She swore more than me.
I don't believe it.
I swear to God.
I need to hear it for myself. When is she coming back?
I might give her 2 weeks because she has some stuff to work on. She dropped so many F-bombs. It was incredible. It's funny because I said to her, so Amy, who's the shadow student, who's with us this week, she was sitting in on it, and I'm like, I haven't heard Amy swear at all. She never swears. And the woman looked at her and goes, you know what? Once in a while, you have to say, you motherfucking bitch. Makes you feel great. My client said this. Literally.
Well, she probably knows she can talk like that in front of you because she's heard all your
thoughts. In the middle of a session. I'm like, I don't even talk like that. She's a great client.
Our kids think that their names are bad. Okay.
Angelo almost dropped an F-bomb at ballet
today.
He
did not.
He almost dropped an F-bomb because even when I called him on it, he even said, no, I almost said flip. I'm like, why would you almost say flip and not just say flip? Because you just said flip right now. He goes, what the f? He said, what again? We're going out the door. He goes, what the f?
I will wash his mouth out with soap. I'm going to ask Barb what brand she thinks I should use.
She just hit me with a wooden spoon.
Didn't she wash your mouth out?
That was her big thing, is washing my mouth out with soap.
Did it work?
What do you fucking think?
I don't know.
No, next.
Tiffany. Hi, Jeff. Hope you're having a great day. What is the story behind naming your dog Girl?
Boy was already taken. Next.
That's not true.
Tiffany, you asked that on our AMA. I'm not going to answer it here. You can't double dip.
Did you answer it on the AMA?
No, I haven't done the AMA, but I saw somebody ask that.
Why don't you answer it now then?
When I got Girl, when I first got Girl, her name was
Stella.
Her name was, no, not Ella, it was Stella.
Was it Stella?
I think it was Stella.
Oh, you told me about
that. Or maybe it was Ella. And we already owned a Bella. So I decided I'll just call her Girl until I come up with something else, and I kept Girl. And you know what the cool thing is? When I say Girl, she listens to me. She don't know. Next.
Rosemary. Hey, Jeff, how can I get my dog to stop being so scared and insecure? She's scared of so many things, including small sandwich bags, deflated balloons, even ducks her head when I put her harness on.
So, well, a lot of dogs will duck their head to put your harness on. So can we do confidence building? Confidence building takes a little bit of time. All I can say is this. The more structure you have in that dog's life, the more you hold your dog accountable, the more you lead, the better the dog is. Watch your affection. Don't try to use affection to get your dog out of a fear state. It won't work. There are confidence building exercises you can do. So anything that you have your dog go under, over, and through are always good. Having your dog hold duration sits, duration downs, exposing your dog to as many environmentals as possible. Advocating for your dog, meaning don't let people pet the dog, don't let dogs come up to your dog. Out on a walk, you'll start seeing better results. Next. Up top chat. $5. Tara, 20-month-old female Dobie, totally trained on e-collar, but jumped our 4-foot fence, also was natural barrier, not anymore. Okay. Doberman, 4-foot fence. Doberman, 4-foot fence. Is anybody on this listening surprised? What were you thinking? Get yourself a 6-foot fence. Or, meaning do both. Put your dog on a long line. Have your dog go up to. Get somebody on the other side of the fence that your dog wants to jump and get. As your dog gets closer to the fence, make it suck. My dogs jump over a 4-foot barrier 6 times a day to go in and out of my building. Because you know how there's that swing gate there, the farmer's gate there? So Kira just jumps over it. She just jumps over it. I open it up for everybody else. She jumps over it. She can clear an 8-foot fence. She has to climb over an 8-foot fence, but she can jump over a 4-foot fence easily. So nice. Paraz, 1-year-old German Shepherd, walks on heel on walk, but wants to greet, play with every human passerby. Should I correct this? Or treat us? That's not socialization. So Paraz, meeting dogs and people on a walk is not socialization at all. Absolutely not. It's gonna bite you in the ass one day. It's gonna turn into leash reactivity, believe it or not. So I would stop that. I'm glad that your dog is friendly, but I want your dog. Why? I want you to be the most important thing on the walk. I don't want anybody else to matter. So I want you to walk as a unit, as a team, as a pair, and you're walking and you're going, and that's the job. No chit chat, no side talk, none of that stuff. Get off the phone. Stop looking at fucking Facebook at your desk. Get to your job. Stop fucking scrolling through Instagram. Cut out the DMs. Get off your Tinder feed.
That's fun though.
Okay, I know it is. Get off your Tinder feed, and you got work to do. Let's go. You can do all that stuff on your own time. Next.
Swipe it to the left and the right.
I have no idea. I've never been on Tinder.
Me either.
Now I would, if I was single back in the day
and ready to mingle.
I would. Well, I was always ready. Single goes with mingling. Goes with being single. Mm-hmm. I would absolutely be a Tinder person.
Okay, great. On that note, my boy, what are your thoughts on slip leashes being put around the snout for leash training?
We don't do that. I mean, I don't. So I don't. I don't have an opinion. Because we don't do it. But if all I can say is if it works for you, then do it. That's it. Next.
Okay. Aldo. Hi, Linda. How are you? I'm doing great. How are you? Hi, Jeff. My dog refused to eat for 2 days now. What would you do?
So I put the food down at breakfast, take it up after 15 minutes, put the food down for dinner, take it up after 15 minutes.
It's been 2 days, though.
2 days is not bad. Is your dog peeing and pooing? Okay.
But what size is the dog, too?
Okay, well, if it's a mini dog, be careful because you're going to have major problems. You want to get to the vet. Is it drinking water? Is it throwing up? If it's throwing up and not eating, that's probably a vet visit. If it's not pooping, so pay attention. Is it not pooping and is it throwing up?
She drinks just fine.
She drinks just fine. Okay. Wait a little bit longer. Wait a little bit longer. You can always call the vet. Depends how active your vet is. They might be like, get the dog in right away. It's like, we've had dogs that have gone days without food because they're stressed and nervous. But pay attention to it. Pay attention to it next. Don't ask me vet. But technically, it's a vet question. Mm-hmm. So I don't give out medical advice. If my dog needed for 2 days, if my dog misses a meal, something's wrong. My dogs eat raw, and boy, do they eat. Next.
Alexia says it was before the live started. You know. It's like talking to a brick wall. Like.
Wait, hold on. This was like, I'm excited to be here.
She couldn't see anything.
Oh, right. Yes. Next.
Yeah. Kimmy, I have a 3.5-year-old GSP. She is possessive with her ball and toy at work in my office. If another dog comes in, she gets an odd look in her eye and her hackles raised. She hasn't been aggressive.
Okay.
Let me make sure there's nothing else. No, that's it.
So your dog, that's the foundation of resource guarding. It's not the worst thing from another dog. I get it. If it was a human, that's a major problem. But let's just stop this now. All I want you to do, remote collar on the dog, just tell the dog no and correct. But I don't want that other dog taking the ball. So that you can't have. That's not fair. You don't tell your dog to out the ball then let the other dog take it, or you reinforce a ball stealer. So, but just tell the dog to knock it off.
You don't want anyone stealing your ball.
No, you don't. Next.
Ken? How long do you work on heel with a leash reactive dog without distractions until you start to work with dogs around? Would you move on once heel is known very well?
So when do you start introducing environmentals to a dog that is leash reactive? What I do is this. It's not just about training heel, Can. It's not just about training heel. You know what else I want you to do? I want you to work on kenneling up and threshold training. Firm, the way we do it. Got it? And coming out of that kennel, if that dog tries to come out of the kennel, you do the door closing technique that I show. I want you to do that. Go, and as far as like going to, a threshold, make sure the dog's doing really great defaults, stops and thresholds. Also, at the beginning of the walk outside, I want that dog to be no scanning. So make sure that dog is not scanning at the beginning of the walk. If it is, correct firmly. Next.
Luck and charm. Hey guys, when outside in yard, my dogs are playing. My one-year-old female gets extremely rough with our two-year-old. Should I correct high on this?
You tell me. Does it ever lead to anything? Can you stop it with a quick or command? I allow my personal dogs with each other to play extremely rough, but I have two requirements. It never leads to a fight, and I can just go enough. In that tone of voice, enough, and they stop. They literally just like immediately stop. They go from play fighting to stopping and just walking around. If you can't, don't start something you can't stop. But rough play is safe for dogs that know each other, that don't lead to fights. Next.
Okay. Amber, is it okay to leave bones out around the house even if there are no territorial and guarding issues?
I don't. I mean, Mac, who lives in our front yard, he's got 3 or 4 bones out there, I see. He leaves them out there. I don't give a shit, you know? I'm not a big fan of leaving toys or bones outside in your house at all. But if it's not leading to any negative behaviors, which there might be negative behaviors you're not associating them with, then if that's what you want to do, having bones all over your house, that's up to you. Next.
Shayna. Got new client that absolutely shocked me with problem they are having with 7-year-old female Shih Tzu Maltese they've had since 8 weeks old. Dog just started peeing on husband's side of the bed and climbed on.
Mm-hmm.
Is there anything else?
Yep.
I don't see.
Okay. So this is what I would say. So that doesn't surprise me at all. This is what I want you to do is what's the dog doing in the bed? That's what I would say. Number one, that's the big thing. What's the dog doing in the bed? Why is the dog all of a sudden starting to piss? Wait, hold on. They've had it since it was 8 weeks old or just started peeing. So like, what could we possibly connect to that? What could we possibly connect to that? We can't connect, oh, the dog's upset with the husband. We can't do that. That's too simple and human, and that would be humanizing the hell out of that dog. We can't really say, well, maybe they're having relationship issues and the dog is siding with the wife. Like, we can't go there. That's just not realistic. Why is the dog doing it? I don't know. How to stop it? That's my level of expertise. Now, how do you stop something like that? Well, you can make life easy. Don't let the dog in the bed. But you can also try to catch the dog in the act. And then that dog would get corrected so hard, it probably wouldn't want to pee for a couple days. That was being sarcastic there, the end part. Only one day, you wouldn't want to pee. So that would be a very high punisher because there's no medical reason. That's absolutely a voluntary act. It's a choice. The dog didn't have to do that. Therefore, it's correctable. Next.
Alexis says, I also have my first Skype client on Friday, totally different owner and dog than the previous one mentioned.
Awesome. Congratulations. Next.
Mrs. Truman. Why does my dog fall asleep when I put his muzzle on within 5 minutes unless doing active training?
Probably because it calms the dog down. Muzzles in general are a pressure source. So it's a pressure source. It calms the dog down. So it probably takes the arousal out of the dog. So it's not a bad thing. Next. It doesn't shut the dog down. If anybody says, oh, your dog's shut down. No, it's not. It calms the dog down. It's a humongous difference. Next.
This one's from Jessica. My dog is fine around strangers unless they look at or talk to him.
Which doesn't happen ever.
Having trouble figuring out how to stop this reactivity because I can't always predict strangers' behaviors. He barks uncontrollably.
Well, you know, you actually don't want to predict it. In other words, it's always going to happen. Right? I mean, you can't tell someone not to look at your dog. That's like, Jessica, okay, don't look at my boobs. Hello? Eyes are going right at your boobs. It's just the way it works. It's like, so people are always going to look at your dog. It's up to you, and don't tell me not to look at your dog. I'm like, I'll look at your dog if I want to. It's up to you to get your dog to get over it. Now, can you stop somebody from like crouching down and getting in your dog's face? That you can do. That's just plain stupidity. But if I'm walking down the street, I can look at your dog. What you do is you do a count. We would use a clicker and food to counter condition it. And the barking uncontrollably, that's easy. Just tell the dog to shut the F up. So no leash pop. That's easy to do. And if anybody ever tells you that, oh, the dog will have a negative association with a human, that's a big fat lie. I've got a new meme post coming out. It's called, I'm not going to say what it's called because a lot of people have been putting out a lot of my stuff 2 days before I can put it out. So, but you'll see it. I can talk about it. All right, next.
Tara, 12-week male Doberman, 3 weeks after ear cropping, healing nicely, but he turns into 100-pound Hulk when I change his tape. Cropping. He bit my finger so hard Tuesday night. Not my first Dobie or crop.
Cool. Tara, excellent. And no one should be passing judgment on Tara about cropping her ears. That's her own personal decision whatsoever. And it's no different than spay or neutering. And, you know, we're not going to go there. So I just won't allow anybody to go there on that one because I know what people are already thinking. And it's got nothing to do with, how would you feel if we cut your ears? It's like bullshit. Dogs will bite your hand for putting a collar on and off. Dogs will bite your hand for grooming them. Dogs will bite your hand for putting ear medicine in, for cleaning out eye boogers, for brushing their teeth, for all kinds of stuff. So what you need to do is you muzzle up for now, muzzle up the dog, and start counter conditioning it with food. Next.
Melissa put up a link to look at how to Skype with you.
Awesome. Thanks.
Shayna. Dining room chair, got on dining room table, and peed shit.
Yes, I told
them about crate, etc., but why would a dog do this suddenly?
I mean, you can they can always get medical done. But you know what, though? They're going to go to the vet. They're going to go to the vet, and they're going to be like, let's run a bunch of blood tests. Blood tests? What blood test exactly? After you run the blood test, this is what I want you to do. Have them draw the blood, but don't tell what the problem is. I would love to see the person at the freaking blood testing center come back with the results, and the results say, oh, these are the, your dog must be shitting on the table, because that's what these results say. Like, even they're even better than that. They're like, oh, the last time we saw results like this, the dog was pissing on the right side of the bed. We've never seen it on the left side of the bed, just the right side. Is that the case? No. So I doubt it's medical. It's behavioral. So what in the house has changed? What's changed? Money issues. Okay? Child rearing issues. Job loss. More stress. Arguing in the marriage. Moving. New people coming in the house. People leaving the house, new dog, new cat, dog or cat die. What's changed? Something in the house has changed. What is it? But I'll still have, but that's the why. Who gives a shit? How do you stop it? If a dog ever climbed up on my fucking table, number one, they would be corrected. Number took a shit? No, not allowed. That's all optional stuff. That takes effort to do. Next.
This one's, wait a minute. I feel like
I'm amethyst. Amethyst, yep.
Mm-hmm. Oh, here we go. Wait.
I know, but you, we have dead air right now. Just read a question.
My questions are messed up.
Okay.
There's another question from Amethyst that we already answered, I think, okay. About the prong.
Yep.
Help.
Okay, Shannon says, sometimes I feel like I'm losing my mind or being punked. Oh. Definitely looking forward to seeing you in Manta. That's New Jersey.
Isn't it Mantua?
Yep, it doesn't matter. Blair, ask Blair's question.
Okay, my dog winces in the same spot going out my front door on a walk. Should I correct when he leaves heel and winces?
Make sure there's not an injury. Is it going down a step? Is it going down a step at all? Is there anything on the, could it possibly, there's something like some sort of chemical on the ground? What do you mean by winces? Flinches, if it doesn't look like that, then it's probably behavioral. So yes, correct. Next.
Janie?
Yes.
I was one of those people that was against shock collars, started using an e-collar. Feel like I love my dogs even more, and I'm a better owner because I'm not constantly mad at them. So thankful I found you.
So Jenny, the reason why you were, first of all, congratulations. The reason why you were against shock collars is because you didn't know shit about them. And you read headlines and you didn't do the research, right? Right. But you now you're open to it. So this is the thing. The lack of proper tools causes people to yell and scream and use more force on their dogs. Fact. It's the way it is. $4.99 top chat. Mm-hmm. Grant, how to stop a dog from resource guarding the owner's parents without using place command? You wouldn't use place command anyway. You don't use obedience to stop an unwanted behavior. You teach the dog out, meaning get out of here. So get out of here. It's the same way you do it with a food bowl. So dog gets too close, remote collar out, push, and the dog goes away. The dog goes away. It means get out of here. We do it all the time. Next.
Rebecca, what's the youngest you've ever seen a solid recall on a dog? I have a 4-month-old puppy and I've been working on it, but I'm curious how long before it's realistically possible to have it good.
It's not even close to 4 months. And that's with no environmentals around. And then the dog gets 9 months old and starts flipping you off. So what I want you to do is plan on spending, I mean, you can get a good recall at 6 months old. Don't get me wrong. But is it good around high-level resources? Is it good around high-level distractions? Horses, cattle, a running dog, deer, kids running. Can you do it in a very crowded area? In a highly controlled area, it's easy. And then also, are you utilizing a remote collar, or are you just relying on food? Because food will fail at some point. So don't worry about the youngest one. I'm not giving out ribbons or medals or certificates on this show. But you have a long way to go. Next.
Ryan, what are your thoughts on what to do when a dog puts themselves in place without command? Do I punish her for breaking without command, or only when I tell it to place?
Nah, you can just say wrong. Go back to place. Next.
Mike, just want to say to those on the fence about going to seminars, do it. Worth every penny. Paid Positive trainer more per hour, and it was worthless. Invest in yourself and your dog. You won't regret it.
Thanks, Mike.
Jessica, hello. My mini Aussie, 35 pounds, acts very dramatic to even low levels of stim.
Yeah.
His lowest level he feels is 5 and will shake his head and try itching it, sometimes even yelps. He's not new to the e-collar.
So you can always go lower than a 5, number one. But also, what are you trying to do? Are you being active with the dog? So active training. So you can go low. That's why they make something called a stim reducer. They make something called a stim reducer. There are dogs that even on e-collar technology, level 3, 4, 5 is too hot. So you reduce the stim. Next.
Ooh, Karen. It sounds like deep here. No fancy pronunciation here. I live in Wisconsin.
Oh, thank you. Deep here.
Deep here. Now, you did say that.
Yeah, but I like deep here better. Thank you.
You said it, though.
Did I?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
So for once in your life, you pronounced something correctly.
Yes, I did. Next.
Shalonda, good evening, Gellmans.
Hey, Shalonda, how are you?
Hey, you got a top chat there, buddy.
Top chat, $5. Ryan, thanks again for answering all our questions. This is my new favorite entertainment. This is the thing, right? Oh, guys, by the way, first of all, if you haven't subscribed to the show, hit subscribe. If you don't like us, if you've had hit like, even if you don't like us, give me a fucking thumbs down. I really don't give a shit. I can care less if you want to give me a thumbs down. And the way it looks for YouTube analytics are like, hey, people are watching the show. So I really don't care at all. You're not going to hurt my feelings. Also, for all the great folks out there that are watching the show on their computers or up on the big screen, this is what I love about this. When someone says this is an entertainment show, you can sit down in front of your TV on Mondays at 8:30, on Wednesdays and Saturdays at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, sit there, have a meal, put your dog in place, grab your clicker, you know, not the clicker for the dog training, but the clicker for the remote control, mm-hmm. like the grandma used to say, grab the clicker, turn on the show. She watches her shows.
The clicker.
Yep, she's watching her shows. How awesome is that?
It's pretty freaking cool.
Yep. You don't need a TV show. You don't need that at all. You got your own TV show here. And there's no gatekeepers. Thank you, Ryan. $4.99, Grant. Can you teach out for resource guarding before proper e-call conditioning? Will that make the difficult e-collar more difficult? Training the e-collar more difficult? So, Grant, two-part question. Yes, you can. Does it make it more difficult? All depends on your skill set, buddy. All depends on your skill set. Next.
Tokaj
is going to be one of my seminars, I think.
Really?
Yeah.
Hello, good evening. Please tell me if it's okay to use the e-collar through the whole act of passing by another dog. I found out that I have to watch the dog very well. Some dogs, he just needs one medium stim.
You can. You can put it on continuous stim if you want to, yes. Some people also go tap, 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 tap. Next.
Paraz, working one-year-old GSD, walks in heel, but wants to greet.
We already answered that.
What?
Yep.
Oh, okay. Crixus, I saw Chandra's testimonial from Collingwood. Awesome story. Good job, buddy.
Yeah, Chandra's was great. Yeah, but believe it or not, there's a lot of them like that. We just don't capture them on film, or they don't want us to use them on film because people fall apart emotionally out of happiness and they feel embarrassed. And if you haven't seen Chandra's story, just look up on any testimonial Chandra's. And that's why none of the negativity against me bothers me. It's literally stuff like that. Because I get so much stuff like that. So much love. True, true, true love from the bottom of people's hearts. You know, so it's funny because I've never hugged so many men in my life before I got into dog training. Just because of the amount of help I'm having. My audience is pretty much female. It's 80% female. But anybody's life who I change, the amount of emotion that it is just, I mean, how can you not hug these people? How can you not hug them? And how can you not offer yourself to be hugged when you've changed somebody's life? So, next.
Tokaj also said, but the arch enemies require lots of high-level corrections until he gives in.
It's not about Tokaj. So it's not about giving in. What I would do is I would just maybe try to get your timing down a little bit better. And then you create a little bit of distance if you have to. Next.
Danny, hi, my 80-pound dog sits by me and leans his whole weight on me. Is there a way to teach him to be less enthusiastic? Thank you so much.
Is that what you're calling it, enthusiastic? Yeah, just knee him back. Just knee him. Just tell me, get the heck away from you. So you can knee him if you want to. You can leash pop away from, you know, away. Use a remote collar stim. Next.
Tom says, what do I say to the snowflakes when they give me shit about prong collars or e-collars? I'm losing my voice, dude.
Tom, you don't speak English in the moment. Got it? You don't understand English. You have no idea what they're saying. You never respond. You never engage. You always ban and delete. Never engage. Never respond. Always ban and delete. Don't try to educate. If somebody wants to learn, the information is out there. I never, ever engage with anybody that wants to say anything negative to me. Oh, what's wrong, Jeff? You're not open to constructive criticism? It's not criticism. It's called hate. No, that's on you. I won't allow you to hate me. You can hate me, but I'm not allowing you to be hate. I'm not being hated. If that's whatever, how you ever want to say it, there I am with my words not being good anymore. In other words, like, that's your problem, not mine. I can give a shit what you think. You know what I mean? So... And if anybody comes up to you in person and says it, well, that's bordering on assault. So then you take proper measures. Nobody has a right to go up to you and to just speak their mind. Like, you didn't ask them for their fucking opinion. If somebody comes up to you and gives you shit while you're walking down the street, I consider that a threat. That's the way it works. Next.
Tiffany said, sorry for asking twice. Didn't know if the Instagram message went through.
Tiffany, it's okay. It goes through, but it gets posted today. Tiffany, I'm not mad at you. Have you ever seen me mad at anybody? I'm never mad at people. So, Tiff, it goes through, but nobody gets an answer till the video is made. So, in other words, and what I think she put it up late today at like 5 p.m. That means it's going to go all the way till 5 p.m. tomorrow, which I'm like, what? technically you're giving people 2 days. So I'll answer those questions at the end of the week. Next.
Richard. Hey, Jeff, are there any good online communities, especially
no!
on the internet, where people can discuss balance
no!
and training topics?
Richard, no. What are you kidding? No. If you find one, let me know. I don't let me know because I'm not going to join.
I was gonna say, why?
There is nothing. Absolutely nothing. So there's tons of online communities, but when it all boils down to it, when it's all said and done, a lot of people just turn into an asshole. That's the way it is. That's the way it is. People can't be civil. People can't be nice. I remember, I've been dragged through the mud on every single fucking forum there is out there. It's so funny. People send me screenshots and stuff. People send me screenshots of stuff, and I'm like, yeah, thanks. That's all good. You should see the shit that gets said about me on these forums. I don't mind either. It brings me tons of business. It does bring me joy. I smile now. There's this one forum that they spent 24 hours shredding me, totally, like really, really nasty stuff, super nasty stuff. Like I'm talking like,
you never tell me any of this, probably because I get mad.
Right? Because I don't tell you a lot of stuff. You don't want to hear about work. Honey, if I told you every time somebody hated me, like we'd need 30 hours in a day. Jesus Christ. We wouldn't have time to fucking chew our food. So, and it's funny. You know what their tagline is? Their tagline of the group. Literally, there's the title of the group and then the tagline. Be nice.
Nuh-uh.
The moderator was involved with it. The moderator of the fucking board was involved with the discussion. It's not worth it. It's not worth it. Next.
All right.
I love it though. It's really fucking funny. Next.
Okay. Janet. Hi.
We had last year.
Did I ask you?
I got more hate than I've ever gotten in my life. In 1 year, probably more hate last year than in 10 years combined. It was bad. Last year was bad.
You never tell me any of it.
We had the biggest year in the history of my company last year. Up by almost 30%, which when you start getting into big numbers, that's impressive. If you go from 100,000 to 300,000, that 300% growth. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. But when you're starting to do really big numbers, like close to like, I'm not going to disclose what we do, but big numbers, it's 30% is huge. Like I would have been happy with a 10% increase, you know?
Mm-hmm.
This year, we're doing 26 seminars. Over 1,000 people will attend them. Bigger than any other seminar series in the United States right now in North America. And that's not an ego brag thing. And I'm just saying you, and the hate is out of control. It's like, guys, it's all part of it. It's all part of it. That's why I laugh. I'm like, cool. I hope I get even more hate this year. Because the way I look at it is like, I guess that means I'm going to even do more sales this year. And the first quarter of this year has been humongous. January, February, March. Huge. Humongous. I'm blown away.
Say it again.
It's been huge. It's incredible. And see people, oh, Jeff, all you care about is money. No. I'm in the voluntary transaction business, which means higher sales means more people I've helped.
We do have to eat too, guys.
But of course we do. But it's like, no, I'm in the voluntary transaction business. If we make more money in sales, that means I've helped more people. And everyone forgets about the $100,000 a year in pro bono work I do, but that's because we don't talk about it that much. Next.
Janet.
Hey, Janet.
Hi, Jeff. I love the Bonker. Those who think that is tough would die at what I thought was 10 years ago. Take empty pop can, put a few pennies and tape it over the hole. You can shake it.
That's common. Yep.
If the dog's behavior, and I don't.
Yep. Yeah. A shake can is also an effective punisher. We just don't use them because it tends to freak out all the dogs. That's why. Next.
Hi, Jeff and Linda. This one's from Pam. I finally requested that Skype session. Sent you an email with video of Andy's issue, my whiny little dog. Feeling hopeful. Ran the fence with neighbor's dog today. That's it.
Okay. Well, Kara can't build a bigger fence because of the HOA. Got it. So you might want to install underground fence as well. So you might want to do that if you have a Doberman that's leaping fences. Hopefully, did you request it or buy one? Hopefully you bought one and then Jessica will contact you and schedule it. Next. Excuse me.
Did you say next?
Yes, next.
Lisa, Irish Spring soap, Mrs. Gellman. It was super effective. Thank you, Lisa.
Next.
I'll keep that in mind. Tara, she jumped 7-foot training.
Yeah, if you got your dog, an IPO or stuff like that to fence, so you know, I would put underground fencing in just to be safe. And you can get the ones you do yourself. Next.
Michelle Hans.
Michelle. I haven't seen you forever.
Hi, guys. Love you. I love you, too. My crazy Gizmo is quite the obedient boy, thanks to what I've learned from Jeff. Still dog reactive. We just avoid other dogs when we can and deal with them when we must.
Okay, cool. Next.
Pam. Hit him with e-collar. He stopped, but now acting scared. Makes me sad. I don't think I'm doing this right. Talk to you soon.
Pam, is that the one that ran the fence?
Pam.
She ran the fence, the dog that ran the fence.
Whiny little dog.
Feeling hopeful. Ran the fence with neighbor's dog today. No, ran the fence. Okay, let's do this in one sentence. Ran the fence with a dog. Your dog was fence fighting with a dog. You corrected it with a remote collar. It stopped the behavior, but now it makes the dog is scared. Don't worry about it. Don't worry. I can't tell you not to be. I can't tell you not to worry about it. I can't tell you not to be scared. But I'm just saying though, he stopped the behavior. That's all that matters right now. Don't worry. Everything else will fall into place. You got to stop the bleeding before you can start the rehab. You've got to fucking put down the bottle. You got to put down the needle. We can't start the rehab process until you are sober or we're just spinning wheels. You will get there. Don't worry. Next.
Pat. Have a Briard, lots of hair. E-collar slips down almost immediately. It's very tight. Can't take another link out. Can I just proceed with it slipping?
No. E-collar prong. You must be talking about the prong collar because you just mentioned the link. So, yes. E-collar, no. E-collar has to be in place. And with a Briard, you're going to want to use thick fur contact points and maybe shave down a thing. But I think you're talking about the prong collar. If it slips down, I'm surprised it slips down with all that fucking fur. I'm surprised it doesn't catch the fur. Make sure it's really, really snug. Not too snug, though. You want it to be able to ka-chuk. But yeah, give it a shot. Next.
Okay. Angela. Yep. Best way to convince a client to use a Bonker. I started my client's golden doodle with a slip lead training. We are having increasing difficulty with scanning and staring on walks on the slip lead.
Angela. Okay. You're training with slip leads? Okay, that's all. Can your clients train with slip leads? Not the dogs. The dogs we get in, they can't be on slip leads. Yeah, we can do it. They can't. Get off the damn slip lead. Get yourself. This is what, Angela, this is what I want you to do. I'm not going to tell you how to run your business, but I'm going to tell you how to work with this client. I want you to think when you're working with clients, what helps them the best? What helps them the best? In slip leads, most clients cannot work a dog on a slip lead. There's an art to that. There's a skill to that. So you can, they can't. That's why we use tools. It empowers the owners. It leverages the owner's lack of skill set, lack of experience to get really great results. And that's all that matters. That's the business that we are in. I never convince a client to do anything. Every client that comes to me knows exactly what they're getting into before a financial transaction is made. Every client knows. They know the dog's going to be bonked. They know the dog's going to have a remote collar. They know the dog's going to be corrected. They know we're going to use food and clicker. They know we're going to do everything. It's all laid out prior to the financial transaction. So why? We don't have to sit there and convince anybody of anything. So I don't know how to convince a client because I don't convince clients. Got it? Next.
Andrea? Hi, guys. This is my first time on your live chat and love your no bullshit attitude. My dog is very reactive. What is the difference between correction and punishment? Currently using prong.
So who's this? Andrea? Andrea. It's the same thing. I use the word punishment. You can call it a correction. Sometimes I probably use the word correction too. It's the same thing. Punishment is just it's just a name. It's making something intolerable. That's all it is. So for leash reactivity, the beginning of the sequence, boom, right at the beginning of it. Any scanning on the walk, even if there's no distraction, correct firm. Next.
Number one pitfall dad. Hey Jeff, I wanted to know, what's your opinion about on-leash pack walks for socialization?
My buddy Sean did a great blog post on that, or a great post on that. I'll defer to him. He wrote it out really well. Go to thegooddog.net or go to at thegooddogtraining on Instagram. Go to his IG stories and read what he puts about pack walks. Read that. I second it. Next.
Aldo says, my dog just ate after you answered. You're that good, Jeff. LOL. It's magic.
Aldo, you're probably full of shit, but I'll take the compliment anyway. So that's good. Next.
Juliana, my dog bolted from my yard when we were taking so out scary. The car from the fenced carport while my husband was holding her back. What do you suggest I should do to correct that behavior?
Okay. Dog training. So this is it. I'm not surprised. We should never be holding our dogs back. It's just a matter of time before they bolt. So a dog that you have to hold back is an untrained dog. Now, that doesn't mean you can't have a leash on your dog, but the leash is there just for safety. Dog training is what does it. So the first thing I would do is, well, it's easier. It's harder to train recall than train don't freaking run out the door. So get yourself, watch my videos on do-it-yourself dog training, DIY on my YouTube channel. Get yourself a prong collar. Get your dog to size it, introduce it, and start using it with your dog. Have your dog understand what the prong collar does. Okay. Get your dog to start understanding a good sit and a good down. Walk with your dog. Start practicing your dog sitting and watching the car go in and out of the carport. And then I want you also to train recall training. Holding the dog back, what you're doing is you're letting your dog load up for speed. And then if you lose the grip, boom, it takes off. No surprise. Next.
This is the last one.
Last question. Linda's on contract for 1 hour on Mondays.
Kaylee J. When I have people over, they usually talk in a really excited voice to my dog, who is on place the whole time, which makes him get very excited and he will start to whine. I don't have anyone pet him, but the talking alone makes him whine. Keep correcting with e-collar?
Humans, you correct. So this is the thing. It's a two-part protocol we do. First, what I want you to do is tell your fucking guest to shut the fuck up. Okay? Is that a policy? Like, let me just explain something. Do you remember, who was that babysitter that came in for Angelo and baby talked to him? Do you remember that? No. We haven't had that many babysitters. They didn't work out, I don't think. There was a babysitter that came over. I was pretty sure it was Angelo. They did baby talk. And I'm like, we don't do baby talk to our kids. Do you remember that?
No.
Okay. So I'm like, we don't do baby talk. You talk to him like he understands the English language. Okay. Which he does. Better than me. Better than most people. And if anybody's ever, you would actually have a conversation with Angelo about just about anything in the world. All right. So tell people, stop the baby talk. Number two, you have to dummy proof your dog. You got it? You have to dummy proof your dog. So you have to set your dog up and literally talk baby talk to it. If it gets excited, correct it. It's not mean, but you have to dummy proof your dog because there's going to be people that don't listen to you. All right. And on that note about dummy proofing your dog, I'm going to end the show about make sure you dummy proof your dog.
Mm-hmm.
Guys, it's been a pleasure. It's been fantastic. I'll be back Wednesday night, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Make sure you check out Instagram, Instagram stories, Facebook. There's also Facebook stories, but it's the same stuff on both. Instagram and Facebook stories are parallel. YouTube, I think Melissa is putting up at least 20, if not 40 posts a week. And we actually are, we might have found a new video editing intern. So we might have now three people making videos for us. We're trying out some new software. So you might start seeing a different style of some videos coming out. I think two or three of them already came out on Instagram already. Jeff Gellman seminars, Jeff Gellman seminars. I'm going to be in 26 locations in 2019, international, back international in 2020. So we're looking for international. And well, I'm in Canada, but that's North America. But we're looking for Brisbane, Australia, New Zealand, Dubai possibly. And we're definitely looking to be in somewhere in like Singapore, Malaysia, somewhere like that. All right. And then obviously I'm open in the UK. I'll be back in the UK. So all you haters, get ready, because I'll be there for you. Guys, it's been a pleasure. Gals, it's been a pleasure. Good night, everybody.